As most of you know, coming up on November 22nd, we're planning a full 12-hour day of coverage commemorating the life and the death of President Kennedy. It will be called JFK 50, a Texas tribute. Don Wall has been doing stories all year long related to the assassination. Joins us now with another one. Don.
Chris, last week I had a chance to talk with Jim Wright, the former Speaker of the House. You'll recall he had to get a copy of his birth certificate in order to vote. Well, 50 years ago, when Jim Wright was a local congressman, President Kennedy singled him out at that final breakfast in Fort Worth.
Now, you know, since I've got you here, we're approaching the 50th anniversary of President Kennedy's assassination.
Yeah.
Tough day. And, you know, we're looking at all the old footage, including the breakfast that morning, where the president said,
"I'm glad to be here in Jim Wright City, about 35. Jim Wright.
Yeah, I was on the top shelf that morning, God knows. I think as I look back upon that day, that it may quite easily have been both the happiest day and the saddest day of my whole 34-year career. There's no way to express the depths of despondency upon learning that your president had been shot just a few yards ahead of you and killed."
A corsage of roses lies inside the car in which President Kennedy was shot. A stunned Congressman Jim Wright of Fort Worth tells what he saw from a few cars back.
I'm still emotional about it. He was a magnificent figure of a human being. There are triumphal things, happy things to remember, and there are some sad things. That day was an emotional roller coaster, the equivalent of which I've never seen.
And at 90 years old, Jim Wright remembers that day like it was yesterday, just like everyone who was old enough at the time, and just like younger people remember exactly where they were on 9/11.
Yeah.
It's the same kind of a thing.
Yes, I do.
It's one of those days you never forget.
Yeah.
Well, for him to say that it's still emotional for him after all these years
An emotional roller coaster. It was he said it was the happiest and the saddest day of his life all in one.
And you could see him getting choked up just as he was talking to you about that. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because that morning, when President Kennedy attended that final breakfast over in Fort Worth, you heard him single out Jim Wright. "It's great to be here in Jim Wright City." And all of that was about the defense industry. Part of the reason for Kennedy's visit was to basically to drum up support for the next election in 64. Mm-hmm. And he needed those conservative Democrats who were very pro the defense industry. And of course, Fort Worth was renowned then and still is for what was the General Dynamics factory, now Lockheed Martin, where they build the military aircraft that we've used throughout our history.
Yeah. Did you get a chance to talk to him about his take on current politics?
No, we didn't talk too much about that. We talked about two things. One was the voter ID law, mm-hmm. which kind of trapped him because his license and his passport had expired, so he had to actually dredge up a copy, a 90-year-old copy of his birth certificate in order to vote. And then I asked him about his memories of the Kennedy assassination.
Yeah.
I wonder if he got to know the Kennedy family after that, you know, expressing condolences and going to funerals and that sort of thing.
I don't know much about that. I know on that day you could see a little bit of footage that we used that he was in the motorcade.
Sure.
And he was only two or three cars behind the president. Yeah. And so, you know, after all the chaos and everything, there he was at Parkland, surrounded by reporters trying to answer questions in the moment. Yeah. Just, you know, you were talking about the news coverage.
Yeah.
And it really was incredible, the work that they did back then.
Oh, sure.
The reporters, they didn't have cell phones. They were fighting to get to the pay phones at the hospital.
They didn't have Twitter. Yeah.
They didn't have anything.
It wasn't instantaneous at all. Can you imagine just being in shock like that?
Oh, yeah.
You know,
and then having to.
Oh, yeah. and talk
he
to
He looks
those
good, and he's awfully sharp for 90 years old.
Yes, you can hear in his speech, it's a little tough for him to speak really clearly.
Uh-huh.
He had some oral surgery, he had some cancer that has left it a little challenging for him to speak. But you can tell, if you listen closely, his mind is just as sharp.
Yes.
And
yes.
His memories and everything.
Good.
He looks
yes,
really good.
He does.
And the one thing you can say about Jim Wright is he is from an era gone by where our leaders actually could work together.
Right.
For goodness
sake.
Absolutely.
Democrats
and
Republicans.
Right.
All right.
Good.
Thanks, Don.
You're welcome.
All right, coming up next, Texas Daily. It's time for a Medicare open enrollment. Did you know that? There are a lot of questions out there. And fear not, we have some answers right here when we come back from the break.